bless the Lord at all times.
Yes.
I will give him praise at all times because he's a mighty God.
Thank you. He is
a sovereign God. Yes. He's holy. I am thankful for this day. There is a word. Every time I preach, I'm uncomfortable because the Lord doesn't give me anything easy.
Amen.
Amen.
So I want you to put your seat belts on.
Amen.
And it's a word.
It's a word. Amen.
Romans 8:31-39. Yes. Romans 8:31-39. And can we all stand? And we will all read. And amen.
Amen.
Here we go. What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he, come on y'all, read. How shall he not also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, brother, that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Father God, it's in the name of Jesus that we give you praise, we give you glory, we give you honor, God. I ask that you take me out of me, God, and I ask that you use me, oh God, and I ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Don't let anything separate you.
Amen.
Don't let anything separate you.
Amen.
Love is a powerful thing. Love is what pushes us to go beyond. When you really love someone, you will do anything for them. You will make sure that they have needs. You will, and it's hard at just any point to pull them off of you. When you love people, you can't separate easily.
Mm-hmm.
Once you just really love people, you give everything that you have, including your life. There are some people I will lay my life for. Mom, I will give my life.
Amen.
For her, just because I love her.
Amen.
That much. But in the body of Jesus Christ, we let things separate us from the love of God.
Mm-hmm.
It says in verse 21, what shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us, how shall we not with him also freely give us all things? We let the littlest things pull us away from God. When it says, if God be for us, who can be against us? He gave his son for us just because he loved us. Freely gave us his own little things pull us out of God's love. Mm.
Well,
if someone says a little thing at the church, they don't do things the way that you like it. We
my God.
My God.
Someone who loves you unconditionally, that gave you stuff, that gave you life, that gave you wealth. How can you step away from it?
Yeah.
It's because you never knew it.
Well,
Paul spoke about all of this because he encountered Christ in a real way. He encountered Jesus' love.
Yes.
His love. shall sweat separate us from the love of God? He said, nothing. He said, I am convinced nothing will separate us. Now, issues, problems, death, people, things, nothing can separate us. But you gotta be in His love. God wants a one-on-one encounter.
Yes.
He wants us at this point to have that encounter that apostle who had Paul. Because we look throughout the body of the Lord Jesus Christ, and it is a sad day.
Mm-hmm.
It is a sad day. We see so many people separated from God. Preachers, prophets, singers, people doing whatever they feel like doing. But yet they want to preach. They just want to sing. They want to do all this. They are deceivers. There's no way that you can be in the will of Almighty God and do things in your own way.
That's
living
right.
In blatant sin.
Yes.
Because we are separated. Paul said, I'm not going to let anything, nothing. And this is where we have to get in our hearts. This has to sink in our hearts that I'm not going to let nothing separate me from the love of God. Angels, demons, nothing is going to separate me. Mom, dad, family, nothing. Because at the end of the day, we have to give an answer to Jesus Christ. We will all die one day. And we have to give an answer for every deed. So why be separated? Especially we are in some dangerous times.
Yes.
The world is waxing worse and worse and worse. And people are pulling away from God, pulling away because they never knew Him.
Yes, yes.
There's no way when things are getting worse and worse, you pull back. God is exposing.
Yes.
He's saying these people never knew me.
Come on now. Preach, preacher.
You've been doing these things for years.
Yes.
And then after all of these a bunch of years, you begin to pull back. You are not rooted in Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
You have been a counterfeit.
My God.
And God is exposing.
Mm-hmm.
He is exposing left and right. And what you hear is a bunch of death all over the place.
Yes.
Preachers dying because God is weaning out because He's tired and He's raising up. He's raising up people that will obey.
Yes, Lord.
Souls are at stake.
Yes.
So we don't have time to be just so separated. How can God use you? You have to be in His will. God is calling for more. He wants us connected to Him.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't want us separated. For too long, we've been faking until we actually make it. But this is the thing, we're not making it.
Mm-hmm.
Because as we see, we can't pray off a simple headache. That's because you were not connected. When I am basically ill, here's just what I do. I lay hands on myself.
Man.
The Lord answers.
Man.
See, Thank you, Holy Ghost. We want him to answer this, and we want him to answer that. But how can he answer just like anything when he doesn't hear anything from you? Will you give to someone that is always asking for something, but you don't ever hear anything from them until there's just a certain need? No, because we won't actually do that. So why do we expect God to give, and we are mediocre?
Come on now.
We can't even come on time. We can't even come to prayer meeting. Bible says like pulling teeth. When you are in his, just a love, you want to be in his presence.
Amen.
Lord.
Amen.
When you are in love with just like a certain individual, you want to be in their presence. You just want more and more and more and more. So it makes me really want to have an encounter.
All right, sir.
Anything with our Lord, have we? Because if this is the pulling teeth, the giving, what's basically just like the, it's hard to get your gift of praise.
Amen.
God wants us, he's putting things in our face now.
Mm-hmm.
It's either you actually just like will, or you actually won't.
Mm-hmm.
It should never be hard giving him praise if you're in his space all of the just of time. It shouldn't be hard to say, come on y'all, let's give him praise. It's automatic.
Amen.
The more that you spend with him times, the easier it is. It's easier and easier. But God is saying there's not enough time spent in his holy presence. And he is exposing it. He's saying, I want more. He said, because I've given and you give me less. Rabba Sandor Shadar Rabahai. God wants more. He said, there is more that I require of thee.
Yes, my Lord.
He said, some of us will be stuck until there's more given, and he wants more. This.
Our hearts.
He wants the room in our hearts. Yes, we can like run and we can dance and all of that stuff. Good. Great. But he wants more.
Amen.
God wants intimacy.
Yes.
He wants intimacy. Because that's where we begin. To basically grow. It's in those secret times with God. That's where we gain our strength. That's how we build faith.
Yeah.
The word of God. Prayer. Fasting. He gave his only son. So why can't we spend extra time in his word? Praying. Fasting. This word is home first. Because I've been feeling him pulling on me, saying, Joshua, come into prayer room. So don't think it's only for just all y'all. No, it's basically here first. So he wants more from all of us. He wants a commitment. God is not cheating on us. We're cheating on him.
Now, Lord.
All of us. We put other things before God.
Amen.
People, places, things, food.
Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes. Yes.
There are sisters sometimes. The Lord has been saying to me, read this, read that. And I said, okay, I'll do it when I get in the bed. And then the next thing, I'm out. No, he wants more.
Yes.
He wants obedience. Paul, after he encountered everything with the Lord, he became obedient. Paul did what God told him to do. And when you encounter his whole love and his world's love, things are going to happen.
Yes.
Issues will happen. But know that God's got your back.
Yes, man.
It's in him we live, we move, and we have our being. So don't get sidetracked.
Mm-hmm.
Don't let these things pull you away out of his love. It's not worth it. That's why Paul said, I what? Press towards the mark for the prize of the high calling in Christ Jesus. Because Paul encountered who? God's love. So everybody be encouraged, but also press forward in God's love.
Yes.
Don't let nothing separate you. Don't let lying, gossiping, or thank you, Jesus. Pastor, can I be obedient to like what the Lord is saying? The Lord is saying there is a snake in the just on the camp. He said, but I am handling it.
Amen.
He said, because I formed this house here. No weapon formed against you or this ministry will prosper.
Amen.
And God is exposing.
Amen.
God said, stop the backbiting, lying, a bunch of clamor, whispering. God said, stop because it's going on.
Amen.
I speak as God says speak, and I don't care. Because we have to realize we have to get to a certain spiritual maturity. We should not act as babes.
Amen.
We are basically still on what? Milk. And it has become spoiled.
Yeah.
So now we're spewing out of the generation. How dare you?
My Lord.
God is holy and God is sovereign. Let us take heed. When you come up against the men and the women of God, Father Jesus, help us. My God, it says, who, verse like 30 says, who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifies. Meaning, who can come up against God's chosen? Nobody. Mm-hmm. Be careful of what you do. Be careful of what you actually say. Because God keeps a record of everything. And God's will go forth. So either you will be on it or you'll be off. Be very careful. Because any way God is moving, and God will always move, we cannot hinder God's work. God has a plan for all of just our lives, and He has a plan for all of us corporately. So when you're in His will, you will be a part of the corporate plan. Right? They go together. Greater faith. It's time to be about our Father's business, and I have to speak as the Lord is leading me. We have let our pastor do too many things for basically too long. She has carried things for too long. God has given every single one of us gifts, talents, and we have to use it for His glory. We cannot ride off of her coattail, because we have to answer to all of that. God wants more from every last one of us. It's not always about money. No, it's about being present.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Let's do what God has called us to do. And when once we are in His will, we will line up. There's no other way that you actually can, because when you're in His will, everything falls into its rightful place. Take heed.
Mm-hmm.
Take heed and just be about our Father's business.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.